गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ ओपन योर बुक फुटप्रिंट्स विदाउट फीट ऑन पेज नंबर 11। लेट अस सी लास्ट पैराग्राफ ऑफ द पेज नंबर 11। आई फाउंड माई सेल्फ इन द मैदान एंड सैट डाउन ऑन ए बेंच। हियर आई इज यूज्ड फॉर हरी सिंह, नरेटर, द थीफ। सो आई फाउंड माई सेल्फ इन द मैदान। After leaving the train, already you know that he was leaving the Anil's house. He was going to Lucknow with Lucknow Express, catching Lucknow Express, stealing the money from Anil. So I found myself in the Maidan. Now, after leaving the train, he was completely lost, and he found himself in Maidan Park. And sat down on a bench. He sat on one of the bench in the park. The night was chilly. The night was cold. Chilly means cold. It was early November. It was the beginning of November month. And a light drizzle added to my discomfort. A light drizzle, and there was a light rainfall. It was raining lightly. Added to my discomfort, and he felt discomfort. So there were two reasons of his feeling discomfort. First, there was cold, and second, there was drizzle, there was shower of rain. So soon it was raining quite heavily. Very soon it started raining cats and dogs. My shirt and pajamas stuck to my skin because his cloth was completely drenched, so they came close to the through the skin of whom? Hari Singh, the narrator, the thief. And a cold wind blew the rain across my face. Now he felt cold wind to his face. What was passing through his face? Cold wind was passing through his face. Now turn over the page number 12. I went back to the bazaar. Now he returned to market. Who did return to market? Yes, narrator Hari Singh, and sat down in the shelter of the clock tower. And he sat where? Below the clock tower. There was no rainfall, means there was a roof, and he sat under the tower. The clock showed midnight. According to tower clock, he saw that it was midnight. I felt for the notes. Now he felt the presence of notes in his pocket. They were damp. They were drenched. What were drenched? The notes. Notes became wet because of drizzling, because of rainfall from the rain. Anil's money. The notes were the money of Anil. In the morning, he would probably have given me 2 or 3 rupees to go to the cinema. But now I had it all. In the morning time, if he were there with Anil, then there was a possibility that in the morning Anil would give him some rupees. How much? Many rupees? 3 rupees. For what? To go to the cinema. From those notes. But now I had it all. But he had stolen all the amount of Anil. I could not cook his meals as he was away from Anil. So he could not prepare meal for him. Run to the bazaar. He could not go running to market or learn to write whole sentences anymore. He could not learn writing complete sentences as Anil helped him in writing sentences. I had forgotten about them in the excitement of the theft because he was excited for the stealing of the money. So he forgot all these things. What did he forget? He forgot that he was to go to the market, he would get some money for cinema, and he taught him learning how to write sentences. All these things he had forgotten because he paid all his attention towards stealing of the money. So I knew could one day bring me more than a few hundred rupees. Whole sentences. If he would be able to write complete sentences, then he knew that when he would be literate, when he would be educated, then he would be able to earn more money, around 100 rupees. It was a simple matter to steal, but he involved in stealing, and something just as simple to be caught, and very simple he would be caught that he had stolen the money. There was no one else except Hari with him, so it was sure that Hari had stolen the money. I should go back to Anil. He started thinking, why not to return to Anil? I told myself. He told to himself, if only to learn to read and write. If he was to learn, read and writing, then he had only one option, to return to Anil. I hurried back to the room feeling very nervous. Now he was feeling very nervous. There was nervousness in his mind. Quickly he decided to return to the room of Anil. For it is much easier to steal something than to return it undetected. It is much easier to steal money. Stealing money is easy, but it is tough to return, and it is out of notice, without noticing anyone. To return the money was tough for him. I opened the door quietly. The narrator, Hari, opened the door silently, then stood in the doorway. Then he stood at the bay of the door in clouded moonlight. There was moonlight, but the moonlight was not clear because of the presence of clouds in the sky. Anil was still asleep. Till then, Anil was sleeping. I crept to the head of the bed. Silently, he moved towards the head side of the bed, and my hand came up with the notes, and he stretched out his hand with notes, bundle of currency notes that was drenched. I felt his breath on my hand. His hand was so close to the face of Anil that he could feel his breathing. I remained still for a minute. He was motionless for 1 minute. He was thinking. Then my hand found the edge of the mattress. Then he was able to find the end of corner of the mattress and slipped under it with the notes. And his hand slipped with note under the mattress to keep them. I awoke late next morning to find that Anil had already made the tea. I awoke late next morning. Next day in the morning, he awoke late. Why did he awake late? Because he passed the nights here and there out of the house of Anil. To find that Anil had already made the tea. In the morning, he found that Anil prepared the tea. Why did Anil prepare tea? Yes, because he was still sleeping. He stretched out his hand towards me. Anil extended his hand towards whom? Towards Hari Singh, the thief, to provide him tea. There was a 50 rupee note between his fingers, and he kept a note of 50 rupees between his two fingers. My heart sank. On sudden, he became disappointed, discouraged. I thought I had been discovered. He thought that he was detected. Who was detected? As Hari Singh, because the notes became dumb, and he took one note from that bundle. I made some money yesterday, he explained. Who did explain? Anil. Anil explained that he earned some money the previous day. Now you will be paid regularly. He promised that he would pay the amount to Hari Singh regularly. My spirits rose. Now he became happy. But when I took the note, I saw it was still wet from the night's rain. But when he caught the rain, he felt still the note was drenched. I saw it was still wet from the night's rain because there was rainfall on that night. Today we will start writing sentences, he said. Who is he here? Yes, Anil said. Anil proposed that they would learn. Who would learn? Yes, Hari Singh would learn writing sentences. He knew, but neither his lips nor his eyes showed anything. He knew. Who did know? Yes, Anil knew. What did he know? That Hari Singh had stolen amount and returned. But neither his lips nor his eyes showed anything. There was no expression on his face that he knew everything. Neither his lips, he did not speak anything, nor his eyes showed anything. And there was no signal from his eyes also. I smiled at Anil in my most appealing way. Now he smiled, seeing the face of Anil in the most pleasing way, appeasing way. And the smile came by itself. And the smile that came to his face was itself without any effort, without any effort, without any try. The smile came on his face. It was original smile. So I think the last paragraphs of the lesson are also clear to you. Thank you.